Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Singing and Reading with Alan and Kirsten. I'm Alan.
And I'm Kirsten.
And we're here today to wish you a happy spring.
And a happy Easter.
We're so glad that you decided to join us today. You are in for a fun time. We have a song that we're going to start out with today. This called Here Comes Peter Cottontail. We figured we'd get into the spring mood.
And you guys get your bunny, be ready to hop with us like a bunny? You can hop around your house.
I'd hop around with also us. With you if I could, by the way.
Yeah, you better keep playing the guitar.
I think I will.
Here we go. All right, let's go hopping.
Here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, Easter's on its way. Oh, here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, happy Easter day. One more time. Here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, Easter's on its way. Oh, here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, happy Easter day.
That was fun.
Sure was. I'm going to put my guitar down.
And I think I'm going to just take my bunny glasses off while I read this story today.
Are you going to put them on again afterwards?
I will put them on again for the song afterwards.
All right. Sounds good.
Today we're going to read the story of Peter Rabbit. And that is a story by Beatrix Potter. She is the authoress. Once upon a time, there were four little rabbits. And their names were Flopsy, Mopsy, Cottontail, and Peter. They lived with their mother in a sandbank underneath the root of a very big fir tree.
Would you like me to?
You can show the pictures. Now, my dears, said old Mrs. Rabbit one morning, you may go into the fields or down the lane, but don't go into Mr. McGregor's garden. Your father had an accident there. He was put in a pie by Mrs. McGregor.
Oh my.
Now run along and don't get into mischief. I'm going out. Then old Mrs. Rabbit took a basket and her umbrella and went through the woods to the baker's. She bought a loaf of brown bread and 5 currant buns.
Oh, I like her umbrella.
Yes.
Very nice spring colors. Do you see the colors? Purple and yellow? That gets me ready for football season this fall.
Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail, who were good little bunnies, went down the lane to gather blackberries. But Peter, who could be naughty sometimes, ran straight away to Mr. McGregor's garden, and he squeezed under the gate. First, he ate some lettuces and some French beans, and then he ate some radishes. And then, feeling rather sick, he went to look for some parsley.
An all-you-can-eat buffet here.
But, round the end of a cucumber frame, whom should he meet but Mr. McGregor? Mr. McGregor was on his hands and knees, planting out young cabbages, but he jumped up and ran after Peter, waving a rake and calling out, "Stop, thief!" Peter was most dreadfully frightened. He rushed all over the garden, for he had forgotten his way back to the gate. He lost one of his shoes among the cabbages and the other shoe amongst the potatoes. After losing them, he ran on all four legs and went faster so that he might have gotten away altogether if he had not unfortunately run into a gooseberry net and got caught by the large buttons on his jacket. It was a blue jacket with brass buttons, quite new. I wonder what's going to happen to Peter. He should have listened to his mommy. Peter gave himself up for lost and he shed big tears, but his sobs were overheard by some friendly sparrows, who flew to him in great excitement and implored him to exert himself. Mr. McGregor came up with a sieve, which he intended to pop on top of Peter. But Peter wriggled out just in time, leaving his jacket behind, and rushed into the tool shed and jumped into a can. It would have been a beautiful thing to hide in if it had not had so much water in it. Mr. McGregor was quite sure that Peter was somewhere in the tool shed, perhaps hidden underneath a flower pot. He began to turn them over carefully, looking under every flower pot. Presently, Peter sneezed. Kerty, choo! Mr. McGregor was after him in no time and tried to put his foot upon Peter, who jumped out of the window, upsetting three plants. The window was too small for Mr. McGregor, and he was tired of running after Peter. He went back to his work. Peter sat down to rest. He was out of breath and trembling with fright, and he had not the least idea which way to go. Also, he was very damp from sitting in that can. After a time, he began to wander about, going lippity-lippity, not very fast, looking all around. He found a door in the wall, but it was locked, and there was no room for a fat little rabbit to squeeze underneath. An old mouse was running in and out over the stone doorstep, carrying peas and beans to her family in the wood. Peter asked her the way to the gate, but she had such a large pea in her mouth that she could not answer. She only shook her little head at him. Peter began to cry. Then he tried to find his way straight across the garden, but he became more and more puzzled. Presently, he came to a pond where Mr. McGregor filled his water cans. A white cat was staring at some goldfish. She sat very, very still, but now and then the tip of her tail twitched as if it were alive. Peter thought it best to go away without speaking to her. He had heard about cats from his cousin, little Benjamin Bunny. He went back towards the tool shed, but suddenly, quite close to him, he heard the noise of a hoe. Scritch, scratch, scratch, scritch. Peter scuttered underneath the bushes, but presently, as nothing happened, he came out and climbed upon a wheelbarrow and peeped over. The first thing he saw was Mr. McGregor hoeing onions. His back was turned towards Peter, and beyond him was the gate. I wonder what Peter's gonna do.
I wonder, can you spot Mr. McGregor? Up in the corner of that one page over there hoeing
scritch,
his onions.
Scratch, scratch,
yeah,
scratch.
This is really a good book.
Peter got down very quietly off the wheelbarrow and started running as fast as he could along a straight walk behind some black currant bushes. Mr. McGregor caught sight of him at the corner, but Peter didn't care. He slipped underneath the gate and was safe at last in the wood outside of the garden. Mr. McGregor hung up his little jacket and his shoes for a scarecrow to frighten the blackbirds. Peter never stopped running or looking behind him till he got home to the big fir tree. Look at the scarecrow Mr. McGregor made using Peter's coat and his shoes that he lost.
That's a pretty neat scarecrow.
Yeah.
I like that.
He was so tired that he flopped down on the nice sofa sand, upon the nice soft sand on the floor of the rabbit hole and shut his eyes. His mother was busy cooking. She wondered what he had done with his clothes. It was the second little jacket and pair of shoes Peter had lost in a fortnight. I am sorry to say that Peter was not very well during the evening. His mother put him to bed and made him some chamomile tea, and she gave a dose of it to Peter. One tablespoonful to be taken at bedtime. He's sick in bed. Remember, he got so cold when he fell and wet when he fell in that bucket?
Nice that Peter has a mom who is so caring and loving.
Yes. But Flopsy, Mopsy, and Cottontail had bread and milk and blackberries for supper.
Does that sound like a good
Peter
supper?
Peter had to stay and rest to get better.
So the name of the book that Kirsten just read for you is Peter Rabbit by Beatrix Potter. And I was looking at this book earlier, Kirsten, realizing that this is an old book, 1958.
Yes, it is.
It's when this book was first written.
My mom read to me.
So, kids, we sure hope that you enjoyed Peter Rabbit. And as Kirsten was reading this book so nicely, I was thinking about a few different things. It's springtime in Minnesota. Today is a beautiful day. It is sunshine and about 70 degrees. We've been out walking. We're going to go for another walk. Well, yesterday when we were out walking, guess what we saw in our backyard?
Rabbits.
We saw rabbits.
There's a mommy bunny. And I think she's probably soon looking for a place to have her baby bunnies. So be looking for signs of spring by your house, even as the trees start getting little buds on them and the leaves start coming out. But before we leave today, we are going to sing the song, Here Comes Peter Cottontail, one more time. And if you want to hop with us, we would invite you to hop around with us.
Can you hop with me, Kirsten?
You bet.
All right, kids and parents, are you ready to do some hopping today?
We're going to hop hard, just like Peter when he was running away. He wasn't even hopping. He had to run fast for Mr. McGregor.
He was on the run.
All right, here we go.
Oh, here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, Easter's on his way. Here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, Easter's on his way. One more time. Oh, here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, Easter's on his way. Here comes Peter Cottontail, hopping down the bunny trail. Hippity hoppity, Easter's on his way.
Happy Easter, everyone. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day today.
Happy Easter, everybody.
Thank you for spending time with Alan and Kirsten.
And before we sign off, we have to show you our brand new poster that's right behind us. Singing and reading with Alan and Kirsten. Isn't that a nice, bright poster? You're never going to miss it, okay? Whenever you see that poster on the screen, know that we're coming to sing another song and read another book to you. So until then,
have a great day.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, everyone.
Thanks for joining us.